fighters that we will hear a lot from in the future. The action continues here at the Fitz Hotel and Casino in Tunica, Mississippi. And on V3Fights.com as we get ready for a V3 Fights featherweight division battle. A lot of fun tonight for the folks here on a Saturday evening in Tunica, about 30 minutes or so from the state line of Tennessee in the city of Memphis. Fights bring out the beautiful ladies as well.
You know, I don't guarantee a lot of things, but this next fight, the judges can go ahead and take a break. It's not going to the judges. Anyone that's seen Artavius Allen fight before, he goes for blood. He absolutely loves fighting in Mississippi where he can throw those elbows. And trust me, you're going to see those elbows.
Well, here he comes, Artavius Lionheart Allen from Memphis and Faye Link's fight team. Fought in January and February for V3. In January, he lost to Joseph Tran in a first-round submission, but he won in February over Lane Mothershed. He's a brawler, as Jason said, likes to stand and bang. We expect fireworks.
And you know, even his fight he lost against Joe Tran, he busted Joe Tran's face up. There was more blood in that cage than I've ever seen before. He's going at it, going at it. He just doesn't have the ground game yet that Jordan Brownlee has. And he's going to want to keep this fight standing.
So again, a fight of contrasting styles with Artavius Allen and his opponent, Jordan Brownlee. We'll take a look at his adversary in just a moment as Mr. DJ changes up the music. There you see Allen getting loose inside the V3 Fights cage, but we'll say hello to Jordan Brownlee, who's from Cordova, Tennessee, which is a suburb inside the city of Memphis. It's actually part of Memphis, so you got two local guys who probably know each other. Jordan Brownlee, USA Karate, coached by Dale Berry, and here's the tail of the tape. Both fighters at 2-1. The difference is maybe the age, with Brownlee at 25 and Allen at 19. And as you said, Brownlee has the better game on the ground. Allen, the more polished stand and banger, a guy who will like to knock you out by either his fists or his legs. Brownlee is a karate fighter, and here he is, Jordan Brownlee. So real quick on these two.
You know, Jordan's last win was actually a year ago in our cage with a submission win in the first period. You know, I think Brownlee's definitely the better polished fighter, but sometimes when you fight a Tasmanian devil, look at the intensity of Artavius Allen. This is going to be an interesting fight. Judges, go ahead and take a break.
He beat Jason Todd in his last fight. That was last March. As Jason said, it's been a year off. Now let's meet the two as we go inside the cage to Kelsey Bolden.
Ladies and gentlemen, official Tillis, you know, would like me to inform you that on Saturday, May 6th, Jazz and Jokes featuring the Memphis Kings of Comedy Tour with musical guests, the Mary Jane Girls. Tickets are on sale for $20 at Ticketmaster.com and in the gift shop. This bout will be 3 3-minute rounds. Our referee, Mr. Eric McMahon. First, in the blue corner, wearing the black and white trunks, he stands at 5'11 and weighed in at 144 pounds, a stand-up fighter. Currently holds a record of 2 wins and 1 loss. Fighting out of the Phalanx fight team, Lionheart Artavius Allen. And in the gray and red trunks, standing in the red corner, he weighed in at 146.9 pounds and stood at 5'10" tall. He is a karate fighter with an MMA record of 2 wins and 1 loss, representing USA Karate and fighting out of Cordova, Tennessee, Jordan Brownlee.
So the last fight he had for V3 Fights was in November of 15. He lost to Gregory Hussey. But again, his last fight was a year ago.
His last fight for us was actually at this casino last May when he fought Jason Todd.
That's right, that's right. Beat Todd last March, round one. Here we go, scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in the featherweight division.
You know, and like you pointed out, his only loss was to former amateur champion, Gregory Hussey. Now we're right back on the ground where Artavius definitely doesn't want to be, but he's got a choke locked in.
You know, Bradley again, more comfortable on the ground. Let's see what Allen can do as he has been working on his ground game. His jiu-jitsu, trying to be better.
Failing's definitely known to be a striking school.
And he's a heck of a striker. Right now, though, we start things off on the ground here early in this fight. A couple of shots from Allen in close quarters.
Looks like Brownlee, Artavius reverses him, gets in a guard, but now he's got to look out for an armbar here.
Now going for a big old. Now there it is.
Wow, great defense.
You see the strength of Allen being able to pick up Brownlee and just hammer him to the ground like that.
And, you know, most importantly, Brownlee had an armbar locked in. And Artavius was able to fight out of it.
Have you noticed when he picked him up and slammed him, he was very careful not to slam on the back of his neck or his head. That's also something that fighters have to be very aware of. They have to land them on their back or somewhere else, but they cannot land them on their head or their neck, and they could be disqualified.
Now Brownlee's in a full mount, so he's in a dominant position. He's going to start raining down blows. Artavius turns his back. Brownlee's got those hooks in. Let's see if he finishes up with a rear naked choke.
Now he's got to get those arms in there first. Right now he's unable to do that. Now he's going to try to attempt it, but you see Allen covering himself up. There's still a minute to go in this round, so it might feel like an eternity for Allen.
Well, and he reverses it again.
Oh, and he gives him a shot as well. How about that?
Wow.
It's full mount for Brownlee there for a second. Now Allen, boy, he's shown his defensive prowess on the ground here in this first round of the fight.
No, he's been active. He's fought three times in about the last 4 months. While Brownlee, like we said, he hasn't fought in our cage for over a year.
Well, they were standing for about a half second, and now back to the ground.
Nice takedown defense there, but for some reason, Allen brought his knees in close to Brownlee, and he's going to wind up on his back.
Under 30 to go here in this first round.
Not really sure what Artavius was thinking there. Never want your knees into your opponent like that where they can finish a takedown here.
Well, he's obviously attempting a choke here.
May think it was worth it for the choke, but with 10 seconds left, he's got to hook his legs. Artavius Allen on bottom needs to hook Jordan's legs.
And he'll run out of time here in the first round. But what we saw was Artavius Allen on the defensive end of things on the ground and actually doing a pretty good job getting out of some precarious situations.
It was a back and forth, you know. You saw a dominant position, a mount position by Brownlee. You saw a full mount, back mount by Brownlee, and Artavius escaped all of them. When you look at offensively, though, I think you give the round to Brownlee. He had the attempt of armbar. He had the dominant position. So you definitely give the round to Jordan Brownlee in this case.
So Kevin Henry, he's in the corner for Artavius Allen. Allen coached by Henry. Mark Beckwith has also helped out with him.
Actually, Kevin just had a pretty public dispute with Artavius and dropped him from the team a couple days ago and told him he was fighting independent, but it apparently looks as if they've kissed and made up, and Kevin's back in his corner. Kevin, you know, he's not going to leave a guy hanging, and, you know, down in his heart, he's here for him.
Well, he's a pro's pro, and you saw Kevin there with the hat on in Artavius Allen's corner. Did not know about the falling out there, at least temporarily. Round two, here we go. No touching of the gloves.
Almost got a nice straight face kick.
Allen throws down Brownlee, but again, Brownlee's pretty comfortable on the ground.
He's got to watch out, you know, for Brownlee here. He's got an ankle lock he's looking for. And he drops him, and he's going to put himself in a good position. Now, you remember here, you cannot kick in the face here. They're both grounded opponents. You can see a grimace of pain on Artavius's face.
It's over.
He verbally submitted. That was it.
It is over. What you saw was frustration and pain, as you said. He goes, you could tell, like, why did I put myself in this position? As soon as he went down, Brownlee got him with the ankle lock. That's the second one we've had tonight.
Right. You know, you'll see guys that go down for a punch, sometimes they're acting. They want you to come on the ground after him, and it looks like kind of what Jordan did. Jordan wanted him to come on the ground, and Artavius fell right into that.
Right, little cat and mouse game that was going on, and Brownlee outwitted Allen. So Allen falls to 2-2. Brownlee improves to 3-1.
Now you see here, you see the grimace. Look at the look on his face. He's saying, oh, man, this sucks. I can't do it. And that's it. He taps there.
Yeah, I think at first it was, oh, my gosh, what did I do here? Yeah. Frustration, and then you knew it was only a matter of time before the pain started and the fight was over. So Jason will make his way inside the cage to talk to Jordan Brownlee. Brownlee, we never really saw what we anticipated. Jason said it wasn't going to go to the cards, and he was right. But I don't know if he expected an ankle lock victory from Brownlee. I think he expected a lot of fireworks from Allen. And it's a very disappointed Lionheart Artavius Allen. But it is a win for Jordan Brownlee. Let's get the official time of the second round. Ankle lock W for Jordan, who improves to 3-1. Let's get Artavius Allen on his feet. And now he's going to head on over to referee Eric McMahon. Now let's get the time.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by submission, Jordan Brownlee.
Well, Allen's still having a tough time right now with that ankle. Let's get a few words with our winner.
So, Jordan, another submission win. It's been a while since we've seen you in the cage. What have you been working on the last year?
Jiu-jitsu.
Well, it's pretty apparent. You've got some great coaches. We hope to get you in the cage again soon. Who else you want to thank?
I want to thank my coaches for sure, because I mean, they get me so ready. And USA Karate, with the best!
There you go, your winner by submission, improving to 3-1, Jordan Brownlee.